Hello everyone, I hope you are doing great. In this video I will be comparing electromechanical relay and numerical relay. So have you seen my previous video regarding electromechanical relay and numerical relay? I request you to watch first. Later you can able to go through this video. The link for watching those videos such as electromechanical relay and numerical relay is enclosed in the description box of this particular video and I button. So kindly watch first. Later on we can able to make a comparison. We have certain criteria. Based on the criteria we can able to compare electromechanical relay and numerical relay. The first comparison is electromechanical relay is the first generation relay, where numerical relay is the third generation. In between, static relay is there, that is called a second generation type relay. Now let me show you one table. Based on the table you can able to compare it very easily. You know what is electromechanical relay, we already studied. Again, no need to repeat. I request you to watch the video as I told you bit early. As you can able to see, there are different parameters. Based on the parameter you can easily compare both numerical relay and electromechanical relay. First of all, let us see the parameter as size. Electromechanical relay is bigger, where numerical relay is compact. Regarding the characteristics, electromechanical relay is always having fixed characteristics. Especially for, we can say, inverse time characteristics or definite time characteristics, it is fixed. But in case of numerical relay, we can able to select, is it IDMT characteristics? I will discuss in detail what is IDMT, DMT, okay, inverse time or DMT. Different characteristics are available, like whenever we are studying about overcurrent relay, there are different characteristics. Definite mean time relay, inverse definite minimum time relay, definite minimum time relay. Likewise, there are different criteria are available. So by using numerical relay, you can able to select which mode you want to operate. But in case of electromechanical relay, there is no other option. Regarding the flexibility, electromechanical relay is not so flexible. Flexibility is due to programmability, that is a major criteria of numerical relay. One of the advantages or positive features of numerical relay. Regarding the communication features, it's unavailable in case of electromechanical relay. 100% it's available in case of numerical relay. Blocking features are not available in case of electromechanical relay, where blocking features are readily available in numerical relay. Self supervision, is it available in numerical relay? No. But in case of available. But in case of electromechanical relay, self supervision is unavailable. Whether electromechanical relay is adaptable? Never. But it is actually numerical relay is 100% adaptable to change in system condition. Another issue, another advantage, not issue, another advantage. Anyway, we can say that numerical relay is always dominant over electromechanical relay. Multiple functions are impossible in case of electromechanical relay, where multiple functions are 100% supported by numerical relay. Regarding the accuracy, plus or minus 5% is accurate in case of numerical relay, but accuracy is plus or minus 2%. Error will be plus 5% or minus 5% in case of electromechanical relay. Error will be plus 2% or minus 2% in case of numerical relay. That is the meaning. Then speed of operation. Electromechanical relay operates very slowly, where numerical relay is very dynamic, fast operation. These are the few criteria. Let me continue the table. Now we can able to say that speed of operation, electromechanical relay is slow, where numerical relay is quicker. Burden of CT on transformer is very much high in case of electromechanical relay, that is not desirable. Burden of CT is very negligible in case of numerical relay. Then consistency of calibration. So every time calibration has to be carried out for a regular time. But the calibration is not required in case of numerical relay for a year of around 20 to 25 years. Regarding the settings, so there is a particular port for setting plug setting, time setting, everything. Time setting, plug setting, these are the different parameters. But time setting and plug setting will be set by using the software in case of numerical relay. Regarding the memory features, there is no memory feature in case of electromechanical relay, since it's a conventional type of relay. But in case of numerical relay, there are many more, many features are available. Okay, lot of advanced features are available nowadays. What about maintenance? Maintenance is too difficult in case of electromechanical, because there are n number of parts. Frequent maintenance also required, and it depends on the weather also, and the rusting action, all those things will be taken place. But numerical relay is actually maintenance free relay. Output relay programming. No programming available in the electromechanical relay. 100% programming is available in case of numerical relay. What about the accessibility of relay from the remote place? It is highly impossible in case of electromechanical relay, where remote accessibility is possible in case of numerical relay. What about the status of service value? That is also not available in case of electromechanical relay, where status of service values are very clearly available in the case of numerical relay. What about safety of personnel? No adequate safety. We cannot able to predict the safety in case of electromechanical relay, because it remains to operate based on the electrical phenomenon, and also there is no separate isolation. Such kind of facilities we cannot able to assure, but adequate safety is provided in case of numerical relay. Then spare requirement. There are need for spare requirement. So universal designs are available in case of numerical relay. Maybe IEEE standard or such kind of standardizations are happening in case of numerical relay, but there won't be any standardization in case of electromechanical relay. Next is support connectivity for present or future systems such as supervisory control and data acquisition, then EMS, etc. Is that possible in case of electromechanical relay? No, it is not possible in case of electromechanical relay. But regarding the monitoring, then supervisory control and data acquisition, installation of RTU, everything is possible in case of numerical relay. Now you can able to tell, or you can able to conclude, which relay has dominant or superior property over one and each other. Surely we can say that numerical relay has almost 100% superior features rather than electromechanical relay. So in this session, I have discussed the comparison between electromechanical relay and numerical relay. So I have referred this textbook of Power System and Switchgear written by Badri Ram and D.N. Vishwakarma. And one more thing I want to tell you, that regarding the cost aspects, some cases cost and complexity is little bit more in case of numerical relay compared to electromechanical relay. Since electromechanical relay is a conventional type of relay, it's a first generation type relay, obviously there are a lot of advancement that will be happening in case of numerical relay. Okay, so these are the major comparison between electromechanical relay and numerical relay. Suppose in case any queries, I request you to put up the same thing in your comment box. Surely I'll revert. Okay, finally, thank you very much for watching this video.